Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be doing a bit of a mashup video featuring the Fenty Beauty Snap Shadow number 4, the Rose Palette for our Valentine's Day look. The second part of this video is going to be educational. It's a beautiful month for facts, so why not go ahead and talk about Black history, which is American history. So again, V-Day / Black history fact. We're gonna have fun, we're gonna get super pink about it, but we're also going to either brush up on things that we've learned in the past or learned something new. So if that sounds good to you, stay tuned. Let's get into it. So again, we'll be featuring the Fenty Beauty Rose Snap Shadow palette today. Beautiful pink colors for a good Valentine's Day look. So here are those shades. Oh my gosh, they are so gorgeous. I really love what Fenty Beauty has done with this Snap Shadow release. Like it's brilliant. And you can't help but to buy like at least about 4 of them. So let's go ahead and get started. I am going to talk through my makeup routine, which usually is pretty simple. I don't get too heavy into like being super detailed. I'm like a regular degular schmegular girl, and I just don't have the use for that. So we're gonna go ahead and get started with primer. The primer that I have been using recently has been the MAC Time Check Lotion. This one's not quite open yet, so I'm gonna go ahead and finish with the sample that I have. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply this all over the face. My skin is combination oily, so let's start there. So I'm oily right in the T-zone and then pretty normal out here. I wouldn't really consider these spaces dry at all, but this has been really good about controlling oil where it needs to be controlled and just kind of like keeping the status quo in other areas. So that's what I've really been liking about this. This is going to be a product that I'll probably use for a while as opposed to moving into something new. So while that's working into the skin, let's talk about some famous birthdays during the month of February. We've got quite a few actually, and there was a couple of people who actually had birthdays just recently. So the first birthday I want to get into, commonly referred to as the mother of the civil rights movement, was Rosa Parks. Her birthday was February 4th. And so happy birthday to Rosa Parks. Thank you for everything that you contributed to the civil rights movement. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and get into my foundation routine. This is another MAC product. And so this is MAC's Studio Fix Fluid. And the shade that I have is NC47. Not sure if you can see that, but of course I'll put all the descriptions of any products that I'm using down below. NC47 has been a really good winter shade for me. It's been amazing. Shade matching is always like, it can really be the worst because your skin changes and whatnot. So I definitely won't be using this come summer. I'll be moving probably back into my Fenty Beauty. I usually wear, if I get a really good tan, I usually wear shade 400. Sometimes I mix it with a little bit of 410 to kind of just bring the warmth down a little bit, but that's usually my base is 400. So there's a couple of actually Valentine's Day birthdays that I want to go ahead and shout out as well. Danai Gurira, and forgive me if I'm pronouncing that wrong, but we all know her from Walking Dead, as well as Black Panther. She has a February 14th birthday, as well as Frederick Douglass. Frederick Douglass also has a February 14th birthday. So shout out to y'all for being born on this day of love. Some other birthdays that I can think of, Michael Jordan. I believe his birthday is the 17th of this month. Writer and poet Langston Hughes, February 1st. Our girl who is featured today, Miss Rihanna, honey, she is February 20th. So happy early birthday to you, ma'am. I'm sure you will do something to ball out and enjoy, as you should. So I do like to apply my foundation with a brush and then go back over it with a sponge, which you'll see here in a second. I just feel like it lays down better and creates a more even surface. And as you also could see, I like to center my products right in the center of my face and then blend it outward. I don't put a lot of product up here on my forehead because why? There's nowhere else for it to go. If I put a lot of product here, I'm just gonna be left with that crazy looking line of demarcation that nobody wants. So we're just gonna keep it light and easy around the edges. The point is to really just look natural, flawless. All right, so that's foundation, that's on. I'm gonna go ahead and move into concealer. My other favorite Fenty Beauty product is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Concealer in the shade 370 is what I am using. So I'll use this, and if I feel like I wanna brighten it up underneath the eye a little bit more, I will move into Tarte's Shape Tape, and this one is in Tan Deep Sand. So some other birthdays we're gonna move into for this lovely month of Black history. Toni Morrison's date of birth, February 18th. We also got a birth date for Mr. Sidney Poitier, first Black actor to win an Academy Award. And his birthday would have been February 20th. I'm just gonna put a little bit of the Shape Tape right in the inner corner of the eye, which is where I want to brighten the most. I'm gonna tap out the edges on this and then let that inner corner sit just for a little bit longer. I'm gonna go ahead and move into the forehead space. Necessarily like to highlight my chin too much, or my nose actually. I mean, as you can see, these two areas, honey, they are independent women. They don't really need no help being lit, okay? Whatever's left over on my sponge is really what I'll use to kind of put in those areas. I really have to press and roll on the innermost part of my eye because that is usually where I have most of my fine lines. So I wanna make sure that product really gets in there. So when I set it with powder, it's not streaky. That's a base, honey. Yes, it's a base. So to set, I'm gonna go ahead and use another MAC product. We have the MAC Mineralize Loose Foundation here. This shade is in medium deep. Not my skin tone, it's definitely lighter than my skin tone, but I like to use it again for those highlighted areas, those high points of my face. I'm gonna take my sponge, dip and dab, press and roll. Really focus on those under eye areas. I'm gonna take a little more and take it, you know, in the center of my nose as well as center of the forehead. Whatever, again, is left over will be what I'll use to powder my chin and Cupid's bow area. This powder will be all that I'll be using to kind of set the rest of my face. Again, I wanna look more natural. I don't need to look like dry and cakey. So there you have it with just the basic base. We're gonna move into a few more birthdays. Toni Morrison, February 18th. Nina Simone, iconic jazz singer, February 21st. And lastly, to round out birthdays, again, this is not like an all-inclusive list, just given some details for, again, this beautiful month of Black history. So rounding out birthdays, we've got W.E.B. Du Bois, co-founder of the NAACP. And his birthday was February 23rd. So next we're gonna move into contour. My favorite contour that I have been using has been, again, Fenty Beauty, killing the game with all the products. So this is the Matchstick in Truffle. And so I'm just gonna take this, not a lot, because I don't want it to be such a stark contrast, but I am just going to take this and contour right under the cheekbone here, and whatever's left on the brush that I'll be using that around the perimeter of the face in order to just kind of like set the foundation for my bronzer. So again, taking whatever is left over on the brush, blending that out, and just setting the stage for my bronzer. Careful not to disrupt my edges because those are important. And again, just kind of whatever's left on this sponge here, we're gonna do a little bit of reverse contouring just to clean it up a bit. right, honey. So that's contour. We're gonna move on to bronzer, my favorite bronzer again. And I'm going to do like a full Fenty face video. I just haven't done one yet because I may as well, because pretty much the majority of the products that I use on a daily basis are Fenty Beauty products. So again, Fenty Beauty, we're gonna go ahead and move into the bronzer. This one is in Caramel Cutie, caramel, however y'all wanna say it. I don't really care. All I know is this is a fabulous product. That's it. I think that I wanna go back in the summer or when I start to kind of tan. Hopefully I'll get me a good tan this year and go back and get Mocha Mommy, which is the shade right next to this one, Going Deeper. I think that might be a good hit for the summer. All right, so just taking that again around the perimeter of the face. And I'm gonna use the same brush and same product to contour my nose as well. I'm gonna take that contour right up into the eyebrow, so again, we don't have any sharp lines. Just dust off this excess powder again. I really only want to powder my T-zone because that's the only area that's oily for me, so I don't really want to put any stock in powdering my full face. It's just unnecessary, again, for my skin needs. Yes, honey. Yes, honey. Why you didn't tell me I had no earrings on? Hold on, let me go get my earrings. Crazy. Okay, now that we're fully together, see, doesn't that just make everything all better? Like, earrings are amazing. Anyway, so I'm gonna move in actually to the Valentine's Day history portion of this video because Valentine's Day has some history as well. According to Britannica, honey, Valentine's Day started as a festival called the Lupercalia Festival. Forgive me if I'm pronouncing that wrong. The Lupercalia Festival was actually a celebration of the coming of spring. It included fertility rites, women were sort of paired off with men as well. But by the end of the 5th century, Pope Galatius I replaced Lupercalia with Saint Valentine's Day. So from there, it became Valentine's Day, which again transitioned to a day of love and romance, honey. So that is your Valentine's Day history. We're gonna move into the Valentine's Day makeup portion of this video. So here we are, snapshot on number 4, Rose. She's beautiful, she's gorgeous, as y'all can tell. I'm going to go ahead and start in the crease. This shade here, Spice Trip. That's the name of her, because she's spicy. So let's get into it. But first, let me go ahead and get some brows on, because that would be necessary. Oh my God. So for brows, I'm going to be using the NYX Precision Brow Pencil in the shade Espresso, and as well as Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is all like rubbed off. But Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Gel, and this shade is in Chocolate. I definitely don't want to go for like a stark brow. I'm more of a natural brow kind of gal. So you'll see me fill in, you know, I'll create a full brow out of what is here, but it'll mostly just be filling in those empty spaces as well as creating some texture with the two different colors. I wanted to get a brow gel that was lighter than my actual brow pencil, again, just to kind of create texture, create a more natural vibe going on, and just to create some depth and dimension. This is usually the part where people have to be silent and take their time. As you can see, I'm kind of going in and out, back and forth with my eyebrow, just making sure that I don't miss any pieces. What I've had to learn with brow gel is that, like, once you put brow gel on, brow gel gonna tell everything. So if you miss spaces, you know, trying to be light and trying to be cute, which is usually what I've been trying to do, the brow gel's gonna be like, hun, you missed a spot. So I just started like going back and forth, making sure everything's filled in so that by the time I put this on, it's more of a full seamless brow without like chunks missing. So I try to avoid putting a lot of product towards the front of the brow because again, I want it to look as natural as possible. So I'm gonna go ahead and start to brush that out into its final shape, its final resting place, honey. And just making sure I get the shape that I want before I put the brow gel on. And again, that's another product that I'm gonna use lightly. This brow is a little more tricky for me because this is the brow that actually has more hair, and so my mind thinks that I don't have to use as much product on this brow, but and then when I get finished with it, it doesn't look anything like this one. Not that they should match exactly, but you want to, you know, keep it as close as you can. As you know, the gals say brows should be sisters, not twins. For anybody that knows me knows that I am a twin, so that's kind of funny. But anyway, I'm gonna bring her on at some point. It's gonna be a riot of a video, trust. Yeah, this brow always gives me trouble. This eyebrow is really terrible. All right, good enough for me. I'm gonna go ahead and clean it up just a smidge. I'm gonna go ahead and prime my eyes at the same time while cleaning my eyebrows up underneath. I don't really get into cleaning the top. It's just not something that I generally have time for. So that's not a part of my program. But what we're gonna go ahead and do is just move back into the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Concealer, shade 370. I am going to go ahead and buff this on my eyelid and then take more of a precise pencil to clean underneath the eyebrow with the same product. So while we're doing that, let's get into some interesting inventions, shall we? Some good old Black history inventions. So the first invention I want to get into is for Mr. James West. Mr. James West invented the foil electric transducer technology. And so this technology is used in about 90% of contemporary microphones. So what I'm using, phones, tape recorders, baby monitors, hearing aids, all of those products have Mr. James West to thank for his amazing contribution to technology. All right, let's buff this out. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little more on for the eyebrow. And what I really wanna do is to pay attention to the crease in this area. The crease for me, I have hooded eyelids, and so the crease is usually a whole problem because my makeup just, you know, transfers, especially anything with glitter, foils, you know, anything like that will just transfer up and it just messes up the whole look. So I really want to focus on the crease area with this concealer. So this again is a product I am going to use lightly. Gonna bring it on down and then I'm just gonna buff it out with the sponge that I was using earlier. Just to kind of buff out that line so it doesn't just look like brow line and then the rest of your face. So that is a good everyday clean brow for me, honey. Let's move into some more of these inventions. So the next one I want to talk about is George Washington Carver, who we all know as the peanut man, peanut guy. He was an agricultural expert with a number of things, but he didn't actually invent peanut butter. He made a lot of things from peanuts. He made milk, plastic, paints, dyes. He also made some things which I thought was interesting from sweet potatoes. The few of the things that I have here are molasses, postage stamp glue, and synthetic rubber. So moving back into the feature product for today, again, the Fenty Beauty Snap Shadow in Rose. I'm going to take the shade Spice Strip, and I'm going to go ahead and use that for my transition and my crease. And what's interesting about these shades is that they, you know, it can look one way in the palette, but can go on so much deeper. They're so pigmented. I really do love them. This is a good Fenty purchase. So I'm just gonna buff that out. And I usually just, whatever brush that I'm using, will take whatever excess to just kind of start putting that product on my lower lash line. Again, multi-step, multi-use, keep it simple. I'm gonna go ahead and take a smaller brush to just sort of build up in that crease a little bit more, just so that it looks a little deeper and has more contrast. Because this is the deepest shade we'll be using today. I'm not using any other colors than what's in here. I'm gonna pack it on first and then blend it out. So I'm gonna focus a lot of the product on the outer corner of the eye and blend more on the inner corner. And this eye is more hooded than this one, so I kind of have to put this product, push this product up a little bit more so that's not all hidden in the fold of my eye. And again, what's left over, going right underneath. Beautiful. So the next invention I wanna get into is Alexander P. Ashbourne. And so he invented the refining process of coconuts. So all you keto heads out there, you can thank this man for your MCT oil. You're welcome. So the next shade that I wanna move into is this really pink shade here in the palette. Her name is Lil Miss. Pink is not necessarily my go-to. So we're gonna step outside my comfort zone a little bit. And we're just gonna go all in, cause like, why not? It's for Valentine's Day. I'm gonna take this same brush and I'm going to go ahead and pack the pink in on the outer corner and inner corner. We're gonna do a bit of a halo eye. So let's get into Lil Miss Honey and we're gonna pack her on the inner and outer corner. Pack it in, pack it in, pack it in. Again, I had to go up a little more than I am used to because I don't want the pink to be hidden in the folds of my eye. We're gonna continue to pack her in and bring her up, and then we'll blend her out. So I'm gonna move to the inner eye. Y'all know what's going on. We're gonna take the same brush and take it to the bottom. Back to Black History Facts. Next we have Sarah Boone, who invented the iron board. Thank you, ma'am, because Lord knows we all use them every day. Garrett Morgan, who invented the three light stoplight. So the stoplights you see every day that we all use and, you know, have to abide by if we're driving, you can thank that man for that. Shirley Ann Jackson led the research on color ID, which I think is amazing. So again, Black people have contributed so much to the things that we use every day. And Black history is American history. That's it. We're gonna move into the next shade of eyeshadow. I wanna go ahead and use this light pink shade here, which is getting blown out by my lights. But her name is Sleepover. I'm gonna go ahead and put her in the center of the lid. Going for all matte today, guys. It's super out of my wheelhouse to not use a shimmer. Like, I don't think y'all understand. And even as light as she is, I cannot believe the way this is showing up. Crazy good products. Fenty Beauty does it again. Right, so that is it for the eyeshadow. We're gonna move into another Fenty Beauty product. This is the Fenty Beauty Fly Liner, honey, and the shade is Cause I'm Black, okay? Happy Black History Month, cause I'm black. I'm a unicorn. Shake it up, shake it up, shake it up, shake it. Beautiful. All right, so that is it for eyeliner. We're gonna move into a couple more Black History Month inventions, and then we're gonna go ahead and put on some lashes, and we're gonna do a couple more inventions, and go from there. So another great invention in technology would have been from Marie VB Brown. And she invented the early form of what we now know is CCTV, closed circuit television. And so closed circuit television, as we all know, has been used in like street cams, our home security systems as well. So we definitely have Marie VB Brown to thank for that. So next up, we have George Crumb. And although never patented, he was the first to create my all-time favorite snack, potato chips.
Little ASMR for y'all.
Just kidding. Face check. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and move on to lashes. My all-time favorite lash is from a Sephora House of Lashes collaboration. And the name of this one is Azalea. She's not really like too flashy. It's like long enough to know that, you know, you gotta pop up something interesting, but also not like entering the room before you get there. Long. I don't know why the gals love such long lashes like that these days. It's an interesting trend, to say the least. I mean, there's definitely a need for it in some arenas, I feel like, you know, depending on what your career is. If you work at a strip club, honey, go for it. Wear the longest lash you can think of. But like if you work in corporate America, I think it's completely unnecessary. I'm not saying lashes in general are unnecessary. They add like fantastic volume and just really complete the look. There's just so many different brands and shapes and everything. It's a lot to experiment with. So I say go for it and experiment. But this is normally my jam here. Like I said, long enough to know, you know, to create fullness and know that something's there, but not so long that it's like entering the room before you get there. Duo lash glue. So while those are drying, let's go ahead and get into a few more inventions by Black people during this lovely and fantastic month of Black history. And again, this isn't an all-inclusive list, just a few just to kind of point out. So the next one that I want to talk about is Lonnie G. Johnson, who was a former Air Force and NASA engineer. So Lonnie invented the Super Soaker, which we, you know, all grew up with. Some of us are still using, some of our kids are using it now. If you didn't grow up playing with a Super Soaker, or if your kids ain't playing with a Super Soaker, you're too young for this channel. Get out of here, beat it. And last but certainly not least, we're gonna talk about Madam C.J. Walker, one of the first women to become a self-made millionaire with her line of hair care products for African-American women. So thank you so much, Madam C.J. Walker, for your contribution to what is continuing to be a booming industry and a growing industry as far as hair care for women of color. We appreciate you. All right, so now that these are dry, we're gonna go ahead and move into the lip. Do I go pink? Do I go red? Should I stick with the family? I think I'm gonna go stick with the family. These are the Mademoiselles from Fenty Beauty. I think I'm going to go ahead and use Flamingo Acid and Spanked. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Mm-hmm. Love this color. Again, another home run for Fenty Beauty. Do I want to leave it as it is? I think I kind of do. I'm just gonna go ahead and touch up. One thing that I feel like is paramount with lipstick is that, you know, we all doing duck lips, kissy face, and all that stuff, but one thing that really just like grinds my gears is when you're, you know, puckering your lips and then you see that line of demarcation between your lipstick and your lips, like just bring it in a little bit more. Find that sweet spot between bringing it in far enough so that when you do kissy lips, it's all lipstick, and not bringing it in so far that it gets on your teeth. Like, it really is gonna take some practice, and you know, you're really just gonna have to find your sweet spot with that. But man, it grinds my gears when I see that. I don't know. It's interesting what like bothers us. So, I'm gonna top mascara here. We've got the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. Let me just go ahead and do my bottom lashes as well as my top lashes underneath these falsies, honey. I'm gonna go ahead and add just a little bit of highlighter to play up on these cheekbones. Let's go ahead and, again, sticking with the family, honey, Fenty Beauty. There she is, this Kilowatt Duo. And I think I'm gonna top it with another shade from Jouer. This shade is called Rose Gold. Rose Gold is my absolute favorite color in the entire universe, okay? It's beautiful. I just feel like it's beautiful on everyone. All right, so first, Chic Freak. You know what I forgot? I totally completely forgot my doggone brow gel. What's wrong with me? All right, so that's the brow. I'm gonna go ahead and add the Jouer on top of this and put some in the center of my nose up here. Again, not so much on the bottom because she's lit. I'm gonna leave the Cupid's bow alone. I don't wanna mess up my lipstick. Okay guys, so that is the completed look. I hope you love it as much as I do. I hope you learned something new today or just refreshed on something else that you previously learned. It was educational all around. I really am digging the look that I have going on today. Again, pink is not my wheelhouse. This is definitely way out of my comfort zone, but I think that it turned out beautifully. So I hope that you have a Valentine's Day that is full of love and romance, whether it's by your goddamn self or with your significant other, with your friend. Doesn't matter, as long as love is in your life, then we'll take it. Let's celebrate each other and our accomplishments, and let's take that forward throughout the rest of the month and any other month, every day. So again, thank you so much for joining me. I love you. Keep shining. I'm gonna see y'all on the next one.